In a world with a growing population of over 7 billion and the constant expansion of cities and urban areas, it is becoming increasingly difficult to find places that have been truly untouched by civilization. Everywhere you look, there are hundreds of buildings towering up into the skies and thousands of cars thunderously rolling over tar-black paved roads. Although this may not be the case for everyone, I admit to finding myself in the chaotic and fast-paced environment of a large city all too often. It becomes overwhelming to be placed in a world that moves much more quickly than I do, mainly because of my desire of a slow tempo yet efficient lifestyle. My own story of interconnectedness to nature comes from being able to experience nature and be immersed in it periodically throughout my life. As a youngster, I remember going on road trips with my mother and father to all sorts of different places. Usually, when I would talk to my friends about going on road trips, they would often say, "We're driving because it's cheaper than flying," or "We're just going to Vegas and staying in a hotel." The difference in my family's road trip experiences and theirs is that when we travel, we don't pay any attention to how far away it is or how long it takes to get there. Our primary objective is finding the most scenic route and never traveling back the same way that we did on our way there. Despite having taken so many different trips throughout the years as I have, I was only able to have the epiphany of being surrounded by the chaos of a city after constantly returning to a busy and crowded lifestyle back in my hometown of Dallas, Texas. As beautiful as the seemingly nature-oriented parts of Dallas may be, for instance, a variety of different arboretums, trails, and lakes, nothing there can compare to the true natural beauty I was fortunate enough to experience in other parts of the United States. My parents, having been born in Poland and learning to appreciate nature from their parents, instilled in me my love of mountains, valleys, and forests. Once I was able to experience the immense glory of the towering mountains, lush fields of wildflowers, and rushing streams of New Mexico and Colorado, the arboretums, trails, and lakes appeared like mere flower beds, dirt paths, and water reservoirs in comparison. It was being able to notice these changes in my perception of the common world around me that made me come to the realization that my trips to these places have made me more spiritually conscious and competent. Mark D. Suvero's Lowell's Ocean had a similarly profound impact on me as did hiking through the mountains and valleys of Colorado and New Mexico. While there were hundreds of visually appealing and interesting pieces of art at Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art, none struck a chord with me as much as this one did. There were paintings of beautiful landscapes, intricately detailed and masterfully crafted to be aesthetically pleasing to the eye, but the execution of Lowell's Ocean trumps them in every sense of the word. It overwhelmed me merely by the size itself, just by looking at it from afar inside the museum. It wasn't until I went outside and stood underneath it that I felt as small and insignificant as I feel when I'm marveling at the size of the mountains in Colorado. Even though I felt diminutive next to this colossal steel sculpture, I realized that it was something just as man-made that I would find in a city. The fact that a sculpture of that size was placed outside in the beautiful natural landscape of the Arkansas fauna and flora and rolling hills not only added to its complexity as a work of art, but also detracted from it. By being outdoors, the beauty of the piece was highlighted by its irregularity in size, shape, and even weight. Its placement in nature made it seem insignificant, just as it would any human being or other man-made structure. This ultimately supports Roger Gottlieb's examples of how universally regardless nature is with everything that interacts with it, which is essentially anything and everything. My trip to Crystal Bridges enhanced my perception of my spiritual self, just as any one of my road trips to Colorado or New Mexico. It is safe for me to say that even though I can be spiritually awakened and challenged by nature, it is inevitably my own responsibility to seek out that well-being and understanding of life as a whole. As I continue to live my life, I will take part in all that the world has to offer to me, whether it be something unpleasant or something pleasing and astounding, as nature is.